with all the modesty which is characterizing me and the Romanians in general, our borders are much better protected than the borders of all the other countries from the European Union. For two reasons. Because we are at the border, at the eastern border, and of course we are interested in guarding very well on borders. And secondly, because these borders are under scrutiny with very specialized installations and a very sophisticated technology produced, of course, in Germany and in France. That's why, from the technical point of view, all those who visited Romania recognized very honestly that we are very well equipped, we are fulfilling the criteria, but we have to look also at some political issues. This is the second problem which is unfinished yet. And the third problem is the so-called CVM, Cooperation and Verification Mechanism, which was a mechanism invented for Romania and Bulgaria to supervise the way in which we are developing the legal system, the justice in our countries. From this point of view, when President Juncker came to Bucharest, he declared openly in the front of the parliament that this mechanism will be finalized before, I mean, in the year to come, for a very simple reason. First of all, he said, because it's my last year of mandate, and I will not live here without solving this problem. And from our point of view, we said, it's obligatory because in 2019, Romania, 1st of January, Romania will become, will be the president of the Council of the European Union, and it will be a shame to have the president under scrutiny from the other members. And that's why, from my point of view, I think this is the third project we have to fulfill. And last but not least, we are also interested in what is happening in the European Union. We were not founders of the European Union. Romania was not a founder of the European Union. But we can be today, and what we are doing is to refound the European Union under the circumstances in which we are living. If we couldn't bring too many ideas when the European Union was created, the pillars of the European Union, whether in this part of the world in which we are meeting today, now we can really contribute to a refoundation of the European Union, which has to be concentrated very seriously on deepening the integration, on having a cohesion policy and inclusive policy, and also the main preoccupation should be addressed to the interests and problems of the citizens. Here we have a very solid partner, which is Germany, and we'll continue to work on these issues. There are a lot of other subjects, but I already, my time not there.
Maybe.
Besides the general problems of the European Union, we are also very interested in the new projects. And here we have a nuanced position. We do not believe, honestly, in the possibility of seeing the European Union evolve following the ideas of variable geometry, concentric circles, nucleus and periphery, and so on and so forth. From our point of view, it's not only a disadvantage for us, it's obvious, but it's something much more dangerous. The fact is that if you do this, you'll practically broke the European Union. There will be no more European Union with the same view, with the same values, with the same mechanism for everybody. There will be a separated parts. That's why we believe that the provisions of the Rome Declaration, speaking about the fact that we can advance in rhythm and the speeds, different speeds and the rhythm, is what we have to look at it. But every new initiative for us, we are looking at it with a lot of interest. For example, we were one of the first countries to accept the proposal of having a European prosecutor at the level of the European Union. Others did not agree on that. They are thinking about it. They will adopt a decision. We also decided to join the security and defense policy of the European Union. This is one of the main subjects which is under discussion in the European Union. Taking also into account the different events which took place in the world, it's